As of December 15th of 2024, there are currently 42 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is 4 less than were erupting last week. One of these erupting volcanoes, representing North America's tallest actively erupting volcano, can be found a mere 70 kilometers southeast of Mexico City. There, the summit of the 22-kilometer-wide great-topped Popocatépetl volcano towers to an impressive height of 5,393 meters or 17,694 feet. Popocatépetl has been near-continuously erupting since 1994, largely producing Volcanian and sometimes Strombolian explosions. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In Japan, the Kirishima volcano's alert level was raised to yellow in response to fairly recent ground deformation and an increased rate of earthquakes underneath its Shinmodaki vent, which has not erupted since 2018. Meanwhile, in Tonga, the planet's newest volcanic island continued to grow, adding 3.74 acres of new land in the last week. And, in what is this week's top story, the Kanlaon volcano in the Philippines produced what may have been its largest eruption on record, leading to the evacuation of 87,000 people. This eruption began at 3:03 p.m. local time on December 9th with a powerful explosion that even created a visible shockwave due to the area's high humidity at the time. Three distinct explosions occurred one after the other, with the second blast containing the densest and thus most significant portion of erupted material. Due to its high density, this material collapsed back to the ground, generating a series of 800 degrees Celsius pyroclastic flows which swept down Kanlaon's flanks at speeds of 81 miles per hour or 131 kilometers per hour. Simultaneously, a plume of ash shot high into the atmosphere, reaching an altitude of 6,706 meters or 22,000 feet. By the time this 3-minute and 55-second eruption ended, a total of 5.41 square kilometers had been incinerated by pyroclastic flows and surges, with these superheated gas currents traveling up to 3.4 kilometers or 2.11 miles away from Kanlaon's summit, representing a mid-NVEI-2 eruption. As the aforementioned plume of ash continued to rise, it drifted towards the west, causing a layer of ash to fall on three separate islands. While Kanlaon's alert level was quickly raised from 2 to 3, thus triggering tens of thousands of evacuations due to the 6-kilometer exclusion zone it carried with it, there is now another problem on our hands. And no, I am not talking about the still existing potential that a more significant or prolonged eruption could occur. After all, Kanlaon had already been weakly erupting, hence its occasional weak ash plumes for 2 months now, dating all the way back to October 18th. Instead, there is a chance that a weather system could form a cyclone to be named Kirishima, which could dump heavy amounts of rain on areas which have received ashfall from this eruption. This would be likely to remobilize all of the eruptive products into dangerous lahars which could affect areas far away from the volcano, much like sadly occurred after Typhoon Durian dropped heavy rainfall after a medium-sized eruption of the Mayon volcano in 2006. If this worst-case scenario were to occur, the number of evacuated people would need to be greatly expanded to 139,000 people. Meanwhile, in Tonga, the world's newest volcanic island began its fourth eruption this month since it rose above the ocean's surface on September 10, 2022. It is now day 13 of its eruption, and in the time since, two viscous lobes of presumably dacite lava have advanced towards the northeast and west-southwest. During the last week in particular, this process has added 15,936 square meters or 3.74 acres of new land, and remember, this island is likely to continue further going before its eruption ceases. As a result, the Home Reef Island is now more than 4 American football fields larger than Ellis Island. And, in Japan, the alert level was raised at the Kirishima volcano on December 12 due to the likely detection of ground deformation at its Shinmodaki crater since November, and, more recently, an increase in the rate of its earthquakes. As one of the most active volcanoes in all of Japan, alert level increases are fairly common at Kirishima. Since 1979, its central vent known as Shimodaki has been the site of all 7 volcanic eruptions. While the risk of an unexpected volcanic eruption is still fairly low, one could still occur, hence the raised alert level, so a 2-kilometer exclusion zone was put in place around Shinmodaki's crater rim edge. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on December 14th of 2024. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, Elaine Jones, for supporting this channel.